This is the Sunday Motivational Video. Every Sunday, we bring you a different type of video, which should improve your life. Today, we're looking at 15 jobs that will thrive in the future. Welcome to alux.com, the place where future billionaires come to get inspired. Hello, Aluxers. It's great to be back for another Sunday motivational video. We decided to do something a little different today, and instead of focusing on within yourself or the ability to thrive, let's look into the future. It's true that AI and automation will wreak havoc among the workforce, rendering a large portion of the population useless and without economic value. Not only will it take your jobs, but it will make the rich even richer. With that said, it might be wise to consider some of the fields which will see an uptick in productivity in the following years. If you're new here, welcome! Be sure to subscribe and follow us on Instagram at Alux. Here are the 15 jobs that will thrive in the future. Number 1. Robot Manufacturer and Service Management. People look at the likes of Boston Dynamics and scratch their heads. Although impressive, their robots are nowhere near close to what a human can do. What you should understand is that it's not about the end goal. Instead, it's about progress. If you focus on how much progress you've made in the last couple of years and assume the industry will keep up at a similar pace, you might be out of a job fairly soon. The biggest e-commerce stores and factories already employ large amounts of robots. 40% of the world's robots are currently in the auto industry, but other sectors want in. As of 2018, on average, one droid equals 5.6 paid workers, according to research. And the number of robots in the workspace is expected to triple in the next 10 years. So where do you come in? Someone will have to build those robots. The thing is, it's probably going to be robots building them as well, so your only shot is to be one of the people that builds the robots which builds other robots. If you don't make the cut there, you might want to focus on robot maintenance. These things will require upgrades, updates, and have their oil changed. Somebody's got to take care of the robots. This might not sound glamorous, but it will, however, be a highly lucrative business. Number 2. Raw Materials Management. Okay, there'll be robots in the future doing most things. A productive way to approach this issue is, what are robots made of? What about the world we live in? Break that down and you're off to a great start. Raw materials is the new name of the game. We're already seeing countries like China use the money they earn from selling you all those plastic toys to purchase everything they can get their hands on in terms of raw materials. As of 2018, China continues to gobble up the world's commodities, setting new records for consumption of everything from crude oil to soybeans. China surpassed the US as the world's biggest oil importer in 2017. It also dominates when it comes to iron, coal, copper, and mineral fuels. Although the entire chain from extracting to delivery to refining will be impacted by automation, there'll still be a great need for skilled workers that can manage and make sure everything is on track. And that right there is your angle. Number 3. Big Data and AI Scientists. Algorithms will take over analytics. They already are able to crawl through massive quantities of data and pull out relevant summaries. Where do you come in? Someone needs to program the AI when it comes to what to look for and what we need it to bring back from the mountains of data we're currently feeding into the internet. People from the IT industry will see the rise of AI pretty quickly, not in the way most people expect it to be, but in a massive improvement in how quickly everything can be done. In just a few years, a single person will have a whole suite of simplified tools which you can use to replace an entire division. You're either going to be the guy that uses the new tools, or you're going to be out there looking for work. Make your choice. Number 4. Artificial Bodies Manufacturer. Artificial bodies is likely to be the most lucrative industry of the 22nd century. The market is likely to be split between augmented bodies and full-on artificial ones. Think of it like this: if someone cut your arm off, would you still be you? What if we continue this process? How much can you remove from your body and still be you? Some might say almost everything except for your brain. Okay, let's run with that. Your biological body is a pretty fascinating tool, which was developed over millions of years and has worked great so far, but to be honest, it does have its limitations. It wears off pretty rapidly. After 50, you start feeling weird. If one of your internal components fails, pretty much your entire system shuts down. It's not super resistant. It needs constant fuel and shelter, and we can go on and on for days. People are already using transplants and are augmenting their bodies. When it comes to how well we see, we either go the cyborg way, meaning you buy glasses, or you augment your body by getting eye surgery. This type of behavior will move on throughout the body. We no longer will be restrained by the limits of our physical bodies. Disabilities will be something of the past. Every aspect, from production to implementation to maintenance of these new tools, will require someone. Find your place in this new world, and you should be set. Now, Alexers, if this is as fascinating for you as it is for us, we recommend you pick up an incredible book called Homo Deus by Yuval Noah Harari, which takes a realistic approach at what the future might look like from a technological perspective. The audiobook version of this is pretty expensive at $35, but if you go to alux.com/freebook and sign up, you can get it for free thanks to our partnership with Audible. Go sign up and listen to Homo Deus in the car or while doing repetitive work that will soon be outsourced to robots. Number 5. Esports. Esports is going to be huge. Some might say it will eventually overtake traditional sports. World championships already take place in the same arenas as the FIFA World Cup, and in both cases, every seat is sold out. Universities now offer esports scholarships, and money is flooding into this space. People will get mad rich off esports, both investors and actual players. Esports as an industry has been growing by more than 50% year after year, and as of 2018, it passed the $1 billion mark, and it's not even mainstream yet. The esports industry is the new gold rush in terms of potential and fairly low barriers of entry. The main three types of investors in this space are current sports teams, which want to make sure they remain relevant. See what Manchester United is doing right now? Celebrities, who look at it as a risk-reward perspective as a great place to park some cash. Shaq, Magic Johnson, and Steve Aoki are just a few of the growing number of celebrities that are picking up esports teams. And lastly, moguls, who understand the growth of the space and how big this will be from an advertising play alone. Here you have the likes of Comcast, Mark Cuban, and Ashton Kutcher. Honestly, we could spend hours talking about the potential of it all, but if you want to learn some more, why not watch our dedicated video on the 15 things you didn't know about the esports industry by clicking in the top right corner. Number 6. Psychologist and therapist. Mental health is becoming more and more of a mainstream topic. The fast pace of everything around us is causing us to be more stressed out than ever. Social pressure to perform is at an all-time high, while we're being bombarded by picture-perfect lives everywhere we go on social media. This will all get worse, and we all need more tools to deal with the reality of our existence. That's where professionals come in. People who can tailor an approach to your individual situation, who can connect with you on an emotional level and help you heal yourself, or at least manage your emotions better. If we look in the West for how things are going, 42% of US adults have seen a counselor at some point, while 36% are open to it, and those numbers are likely to go up. Number 7. Gene designer for babies and pets. Yep, designer babies are just around the corner. In fact, they're already happening. Before you start freaking out about how we're playing God and doing the work of the devil, let's dive a little deeper. What if you or your partner got pregnant and identified that the baby will be born with poor sight or hearing, but you could choose to fix that pre-birth without any other side effects? What if you could offer your child a normal life through gene editing? Would you do it? Of course you would. We have a brand new technology called CRISPR, which allows us to remove certain genes and replace them with new ones. This is probably the biggest leap and technological breakthrough of our century, but it's still in the early stages. The thing is, we already proved that it works. Now we have to figure out what we can do with it. Once we start correcting unwanted defects in the human body, there's a very small step towards adding things we might find useful, like better physicality, better metabolism, and other attributes in general. Perhaps the first sector we'll see this implemented in is pets. You'll be able to design your own perfect pet, the same way you create a new character in Sims or whatever MMO people are into these days. Damn, we're old. Number 8. Virtual World Designer. VR and AR are the new frontier, an unexplored land filled with potential and awaiting to be built. That's where you come in. Somebody will have to design everything in our newfound worlds, from buildings to chairs to what inhabits it and more. Even better, you're no longer limited by the restraints of the real world. Currently, 4.2 billion people are connected to the internet, meaning they have some sort of virtual footprint in a digital world. Adoption of immersive VR will be slow, and it's likely to start with entertainment at first. But virtual worlds will not be for gaming purposes alone. It will be a lot more cost-efficient to use virtual worlds as our main transactional and interactive environment. Why spend 2 hours in traffic to get to a meeting when we can just put on our goggles and meet at a virtual office? We're already doing most of our interactions with others in the virtual space. You talk to people on WhatsApp, you look at their travel pics on Instagram, and consume this video on YouTube. You don't need to leave the house for any of these. Virtual worlds are the natural progression of these technologies and will be a part of our lives way sooner than you think. Number 9. Cybersecurity and Private Data Brokerage. As we live more and more of our lives in the digital realm, cybersecurity will become more and more relevant to all of us. We are already seeing worldwide debates about how our data is handled by big corporations. People have been giving away their data for free because they don't realize how valuable this type of information actually is. Before social media and cookies, you had to spend millions of dollars to get your hands on this type of info, but now people give it away for free in exchange for memes and funny videos. Social platforms got the bargain of the century, making billions of dollars off of your data, and governments have no idea what's actually happening. On average, a US consumer's data is worth at least $240 per year to companies like Facebook or Google. Data brokerage is already a billion-dollar industry, but it's not as public as the rest, so people ignore it. Cambridge Analytica was just a glimpse into what kind of impact this type of brokerage can have on the world, and everybody started freaking out. Number 10. Entertainment. Entertainment is at an all-time high. Never before have we been so obsessed on fitting so much entertainment as possible into our daily lives. People binge-watch entire seasons of Netflix. We're at the 9th Fast and the Furious movie. Who needs 9 of these? Streaming is blowing up. People spend hours watching other people do things. Why? Because it's entertaining. We are living busy lives, so the option to disconnect even for a few minutes, which eventually turns into a couple of hours, has become a worldwide phenomenon which has survived through the ages. Entertainment is evolving with technology, so it's a safe bet that it will be around for a while to come. Speaking of, you know what might not be around for a long time? Actors. Actors are really expensive, prone to getting themselves into trouble in real life, which leads to financial tensions on studios. Disney has figured this out super early. It acquired Pixar for exactly this reason. Incredibles 2, Frozen, Finding Dory, all grossed over $1 billion without one actor in sight. Even the Avengers movie relies more on CGI than anything else. In a very near future, popular actors like Robert Downey Jr. will sign away their rights to their personas, their looks, voice, and behaviors. Through this hyper-realistic 3D rendering of their bodies, studios will put actors in movies without the need for actual humans to be involved. We actually covered this in our video, The 15 Jobs That Will Disappear Due to Automation and AI. If you want to learn some more about it, click in the top right corner to watch the video. It is super interesting what's going on right now. Number 11, Real Estate Developer. Getting back to the concrete, pun intended, we're closing in on the 8 billion population number. We're a lot of people and they all need shelter. Let's look at the most populated country in the world for the second time in this video. China's middle class is seeing a boom in earnings. This correlates with their ability to spend money, and people are moving from the countryside towards cities. This trend is also beginning in India, and we're expecting a similar result in the following years. People in what were once considered poor countries now have a ton of money they wish to spend. Everything is booming, and real estate is the main index of how well these countries are doing. Sure, there's new, more efficient, and effective tech to build now, but the demand is so big, developers can't keep up. The same trend is happening in the Middle East, with places like Qatar and Dubai literally pulling themselves out of the desert in just the past 20 years. Number 12, biochemistry and tech engineers. What's all this fancy talk about anyway? Well, it all boils down to a few basic necessities: energy and materials. We need better ways to create and store energy, as well as new materials that are cheaper to produce but stronger because we're building higher than ever. The battery industry alone has seen a massive increase in the past 2 decades. Everybody has a smartphone, a laptop, and soon an electric car. Even today, your entire life runs on electricity, and we're seeing major improvements in all aspects of capturing it with the least amount of collateral damage. There's still a lot of room to optimize what we currently have, though. We've been living in a world of opulence, producing inefficiently and in large quantities because there wasn't a need for us to limit anything. This type of behavior has had alarming effects on the environment, with the most prominent example being plastic. We made everything out of it, and now we have so much of it we don't know what to do with it all. We need new materials, and once these are here, entire industries will be reshaped. Number 13, private services for the rich. The rich will get richer, or at least stay rich. They'll have enough money to afford dedicated services for their personal needs, starting with private security and ending with people taking care of their kids. Tailoring to the rich has been a lucrative industry because the demand is always there. Some faces might change, but new clients will always be popping up. There are entire segments of private businesses which exist only to cater to the super wealthy. While the masses will enjoy the benefits of standardized, cheap products created by robots, the rich care about that extra step, the personal touch. They need to have something only a few others have, and that's why they spend the extra money to get it. Find a way to deliver value to the rich, and you're in business for the long run. Number 14, elderly care and end-of-life management. With such a large population number, we're seeing records when it comes to deaths as well. People are simply growing old, and they need special attention until the day they eventually pass on. Elder care is one of the fastest growing industries in the world, and funeral homes have been in business since the beginning of human time. Until now, there's been a bit of a culture clash between the West and the East because the West was focused more on the individual, while in the East, the elders lived with the family until they died. Because of the way things are evolving right now, even the Easterners are starting to find alternative ways to do this, because the last thing parents want is to be a burden on their children, and the children want their elders to get the proper attention they deserve. Number 15. Small jobs that are not worth automating yet. Another segment which is likely to do okay in the future are the small niche industries where automation doesn't really make sense. In addition to those, there's the situation of how remote the marketplace is and the number of customers you're servicing. Being a veterinarian in a remote village is a pretty safe bet compared to being an accountant in California. There are also segments where the added value comes from the personal touch. A simple example would be going to Rome or Venice and sitting down in a restaurant. You still want the pasta to be prepared by an Italian chef that drops by the table and checks to see if everything is okay. You can automate the process of making food, but that's not where the value lies. Figure out what are the value points and if people would be willing to trade your personal touch for convenience. If they would do that, you might want to start thinking about other options. Now, Aluxers, we're curious to know, what is your profession? What do you do for a living? Do you think that your job will be done the same way you do it in 50 to 100 years from now? We're really interested in knowing your opinion on how things are changing. And of course, for sticking with us until the end, here's your bonus. Number 16. Anybody who's in the top 10% of their profession. People are scared of automation, and they should be. What automation will do is thin out the herd of people who are easily replaceable either way. If your job consists of you doing a very similar task over and over again, well, you should be worried. This applies to everyone, from people working at McDonald's to the corporate world. Go into any office building and you'll easily figure out that at least half of the people there are wasting company time doing pretty much basic work or browsing Instagram. While at the other end of the spectrum, there's no need for a person to be behind the desk at McDonald's to type in an order I'm dictating to them, and we're already seeing that start to change. Instead, we're going to the best performers put in charge of overseeing the process. 9 in 10 will be let go, with the remaining 1 making sure things are going the way they should. As unfortunate as it may be for employees, it makes sense for companies to do so from a financial perspective. The best of the best will survive, and we wish you Aluxers the best of luck. If you've watched this video until the end and you want to be in that 10% that thrives in this new world, please write 10% in the comments below. It's always nice to see how supportive you guys are. Thank you for spending some time with us, Aluxers. Make sure to like and subscribe so you never miss another video. We also handpicked these videos, which we recommend you watch next. Thank you for being an Aluxer, and we'll see you back tomorrow.